I said, that makes no sense. He says, and when they came, the police was hard on me for nothing. I said, and where was three? Did he ever get up? Did he have on a vest? He said, in the 18-wheeler, never got shot up. I said, shit's crazy. He said, no. When I was there, he was laying behind the 18-wheeler. I said, where did he get hit and how many times? He said, in the picture, you show it lay on next lane. And I was looking like, what? I said, that wasn't him, fam. He said, twice, chase in hand. I said, so just once to the chest. He says, yes, that man was not dead. I said, you think he made it? He said, hell yeah. And one more thing. I know number seven was not into it with him. BFG is 7'5". We don't like 6'5". And Bubba, he was BFG to that in 7'5". So you was right about seven got something to do with it. See, Beto and seven will never be beefing. They from the same hood. It all acting to throw people off. We got big beef with Beto and seven, Lil Nana and Go Yayo. And that's what I showed y'all. If you fast forward to when I showed the whole beef between them recently, if you go back and remember, all the beef I showed y'all between BFG and Goyeyo and whatever. That's when Trap Boy Freddy gets into the mix, because Trap Boy Freddy cool with BFG and he keeps saying whatever. Okay, once again, he says, and one more thing, I know number seven, we was into it with him. BFG is 7'5". We don't like 6'5". And Bubba, he was BFG. That's in 6'5". So you was right about seven got something to do with it. See, Beto and seven will never be beefing. They from the same hood. It's all acting to throw people off. We got big beef with Beto and seven, Lil Nana and Goyeyo. So once again, I'm trying to piece this D story together for y'all. Let me know if anybody, okay, let me stop. This in motor mouth. Nana. Let me ask somebody right now. Let me ask the room. Is any of this making sense? Do y'all think D is on some cap shit, or do y'all think, hey, this is adding up, this is looking? What do y'all think so far? I'm going to stop it right here and ask the room, what y'all thinking? Is D capping? Is this a bunch of cap y'all hearing, or is this some legit shit? Like, y'all let me know, because these are all the D gems. Y'all let me know. I don't know. I'm talking about, let's see. No, it's not making sense. D is real. It's adding up. D is in on this. Yes, it makes sense. It's adding up a little bit. I believe him. I don't know. Didn't he get shot with three? He ain't capping already. D sound like Cap'n Keith. It's adding up for sure. I'm confused. maybe. Sounds real. Nope. It's making sense. I've been out of pocket, so where is... D from? D is from Dallas. He was on the freeway with Mo3 allegedly. Why did D say Mo3 had on purple pants when he was on your show? Look, man, D said a lot of shit. Let's just be honest. Why D did not talk to the police? Ratchet, I heard he was alive until they put him in that fake ambulance. I still believe he is alive and he is in Mexico. Sounds legit to me. Yeah, about seven, but something don't sit right with D. Been saying D is three. All right, so look, let's get to it. We run Goyeyo after Hood from 7'5". He did a video with us and did not finish, and he went to Trap Boy talking about us, and Trap Boy told him to leave us alone because he knew we don't play. And Goyeyo, oh, let's read that again. We run Goyeyo out the hood from 7'5". He did a video with us and did not finish, and he went to Trap Boy talking shit about us, and Trap Boy told him to leave us alone because he know we don't play. And Goyeyo went to the internet with the beef, and we never seen him again. And Mo3 start coming to our, where I guess he meant our hood. Mo3 started coming to our hood and get people because he heard about, he said he came to the hood and started getting people. Like, he was, I guess he was trying to say Mo3 was coming to the hood recruiting hitters. Mo 3 was known to have some hitters on his team, so he was going to his side of town recruiting some hitters, and he says he heard about us in the streets, so he tried to be on our side to beef with them. This ish is deep, because we was already into it with Trap Boy, Beto, Goyeyo, number 7, and 7 went to sign with him, and he like, damn, why Mo 3 sign him? I told him about that too when we was on the freeway, and he was like, he remember from somewhere, and I told him, Bubba, that's where, and he said, you one of us. I was like, I know Bubba, but I'm a big fan of you though. All right, so he says he been into it with Trap Boy, Beto, Goyeyo, number 7, whatever, whatever. He says D, not the ops. Let's see. D is not 3, and D is real, and he telling the truth. 3 was hit in the hand and the chest, not the head. Me too. That's when I locked in on the show, and he had a lot of conversation on that freeway. That's what I'm saying. So him and 3 had a conversation on the freeway. This is, look, I don't know what happened on that freeway. I wasn't there. This is all shit that was sent to me. I don't know. I wasn't there. This is all coming from D. If you go to BFG Ben Franklin on YouTube, you will see some ish. 6-5 had killed 2 of our homeboys from 7-5, so we've been at it since 2015. That's why number 7 moved to North Dallas, and Nana did too. Beto did too. Beto don't stay in 6-5 no more. None of them, because it is people looking for them, not over Mo 3, over this street shit. That's why Beto said it's a lot of street stuff going on. He know what it is. And him and Trap Boy best friend is close to close. So yeah, he and this ish, and found out number 7 was over them girls' house the night before Mo 3 died. That's what the streets saying. I guess he meant that's what is in the streets. I F with these girls, they be effing on to catch up with them. Now, I'm going to read that again so everybody can catch up. I'm going to read that again. Trap did say on the Say Cheese that he didn't want Trap to talk to Yayo. D came to Ratchet with the information. Yep, those 2 boys out of 6-5. Let's look at everything D has said, and the other facts match what D has been saying. Just stop reading. Let Google translate it. Look, and Google can't translate this shit. 6-5 had killed 2 of our homeboys from 7-5. So we've been at it since 2015. That's why number 7 moved to North Dallas. Nana did too. Beto did too. Beto don't stay in 6-5 no more. None of them, because it's people looking for them, not over Mo 3, but over this street stuff. That's why Beto said it's a lot of street stuff going on. He know what it is, and him and Trap Boy best friend close to close. So yeah, he in on this ish, and found out number 7 was over them girls' house the night before Mo 3 died. That's what's in the streets. I F with these girls, they be effing on to catch up with them. If Sean G was not on the freeway and was in the car with Rain. He said Sean G was not on the freeway. He was in the car with Rain. And he says that's when he pulled up after I left Sean G. He a big key to this plan. To side, I'm telling you, man, this ish is crazy. They was making sure they took him in for he won't talk. That's what it is. That's what they was making sure they took him in for he won't talk. That's what that is. Now, y'all put that together. Y'all tell me what that means. He says, he a big key to this plan. Two side, I'm telling you, man, this is crazy. They was making sure they took him in for he want talk. That's what that is. Y'all tell me what that means. Any Flower says, I said it from the beginning. D might be the last piece to the play to tell or make his own narrative. Nothing against you, Ratchet. It's the wording I took to BC, but like, it ain't. I'm sorry. I'm trying my hardest here. What Gunna Meezy was talking about? What you mean, Gino? Jackie told on herself early. Salute, Lisa. Feds. So who wouldn't talk? Two brain cells dropped here. I'm trying to see if anybody gonna say it. The FaceTime, Sean G tours him good. Talking about the cases, he's also said that Sean, okay, you took that off, beautifully and perfect. She Jossie shooter, so that arrested old boy, so don't tell on everybody. Salute Shay, what's up? Sean G was ratting Ratchet. I'm just saying, your ass, salute Meek and Tony. Keep dropping them gems. They took Sean G to jail. All right, so look, I'm just trying to get y'all to, I'm trying to piece this together for y'all. So let's read that one more time. He a big key to the, hold on. He a big key to this, to plan, to side. I'm telling you, man, this is crazy. They was making sure they took him in for he won't talk. That's what that is. I be watching. It just, I know number 7, Bido, all them watching. They want on me to come in on a lot of ops on your ish. And somebody told me next year Rain is going to sign Bido and Trap Boy. Next year they trying to play like the beef is over and it was never no beef. And if you look now, that information was credible when I told y'all that. I was the one who reported this. I told y'all from what I was told, it was going to be the end of the beef in this year. They said the end of the beef would be this year. He says, nigga, why you keep playing with my name? I don't think I'm playing with anything. I think this is what somebody is saying. And you can't get mad at somebody for saying this to me. And see, that's the thing. Y'all get mad at the dude who's on the internet presenting the facts, but they never get mad at the street niggas that be doing the shit. That's the shit I don't get. Again, they come and try to check the internet, dude. Why you playing with me? All that tough guy shit with the internet, dude. They don't ever go in the streets and check. None of these dudes that be in the street putting this shit on the internet, they come straight to the internet guy who is just reporting on the news that's just being out there. This is the shit that's, you know, that's the same thing Trap Boy got mad at me about when you, sir, you went on the internet and you alluded to the fact that Trap Boy was doing some whatever, and the video was titled how it was, and he gets mad at me for presenting that video out there when I didn't say shit in the video. It wasn't even my information. That was coming straight from somebody else. You see how that happens? Every time it's the internet guy, they get mad at, but they don't ever go check the source. And these people be doing a lot of talk. These street niggas get on the internet and do a whole lot of talking. They talk and then they get mad when the information gets out there about them being on the internet. It's like none of this shit would happen if people just stay off the internet. None of it. But then again, someone sends me this information about somebody. The information has already been on my platform once. This is not the first time I'm presenting this. This is the how many ever time. Those videos have millions of views on them. So this ain't new information I'm presenting, so I ain't playing with your name. This is information that's already on my platform. Go back and rewind, and you'll see this information, it already exists on Ratchet TV. This is not the first time I've said any of this. So let's go back and run my content again, and you will see D. Ben said that about you. I didn't say that about you. D. Ben said that. Maybe you didn't get the memo that he said that about you, but let's say this again. This is what D. said about the whole situation. Now, was this shit true? I don't fucking know. It's alleged. I don't know what the hell's going on, but I'm gonna present it to my people. I'm gonna give them everything. So if that's me trying to stop, no, I'm not stopping. We're gonna keep going, and I'm gonna give y'all everything he gave me. Everything. Do y'all wanna continue, Ratchet Gang? Let me ask the gang. Y'all wanna continue? Y'all mad at the wrong person. They always get mad at me. Everybody gets mad at me. Everybody hates Ratchet. Says Sapphire, your girl in here. Who is in here? Let's see. Let's read this chat real quick. This is taking a bad left. What did I miss? I ain't been reading the chat. Damn, hold on. There's a lot of shit going on. This guy's still talking about the Mo 3 case. 100K track. He was saying 100K track, which is I don't know what the hell this NBA dude is talking about. I don't know what, damn, it's weird in this chat right now. What the hell is D knows a lot. Let's see, a little too much cause you close. They'll be alright. Should have never set that man up. Let's see. Yeah. It's cool. Just take him out the chat. It's cool. If he's spamming, you already know. My bad. I'm gonna let you do your thing. My bad. Ratchet, keep doing your thing. I mean, Ratchet. It said Duck Shanji too. Chat is lit. Yeah, it's kind of lit, right? D is giving the big play. Sean, tap in. That's the thing. He's never wanted to tap in with me. This shit has been. This is information that me and that dude have even had conversations before. You know what I'm saying? For him to even be getting mad at the same information I'm presenting a year later. You know what I'm saying? This is the same information that came on my platform last year. I said, boy, what the fuck are you talking about? Because you dropping gems. They said, is the boogeyman in the chat? Rain, where are you? Hi, gang, and peace and blessings. All right, so let's get back to this, man. D said that he knew 3, but then he said he was a fan of 3. Look, man, D has been all over the place, but all I can say is some of this information comes out. It's weird because some of the information just looks so, like, on point, and if you do your research, you're like, this is, like, real shit. Like, that we discussing there is some real shit. Now, I don't know how much percentage of the shit is real and how much percentage of the shit is fabricated. I don't know. But like I said, I'm gonna present all this shit to y'all. If anybody gets mad, they just get mad. This is all something that D said. I don't know what part of this story to believe, what part of this story to not believe. I don't know. It's a crazy story. But while y'all here, can y'all do me a big favor and press that like button? You know what I'm saying? While y'all here, because I mean, at this point, y'all always on my damn channel, so y'all might as well just become green members at some point. You know what I'm saying? And just be part of the Ratchet Gang. I don't understand why y'all act like y'all don't like Ratchet Gang when y'all know this is the drop right here. All right, so let's say this again. I'm going to get back to my content. Let's not be interrupted anymore. They was making sure they took him in for he want talk. That's what that is. I be watching it. Just know I know number 7, Beto, all them watching. They want on me to come in. It a lot of ops on your shit. And somebody told me next year Rain is going to sign Beto and Trap Boy. Next year they're gonna try to play like the beef is over and it was never no beef. They trying to wait till it gets old and wait till people stop talking about Mo 3 and then it's going to get big if them niggas don't go to jail. I know what's going on, Ratchet. They really getting mad at Rain because he come on your show and they don't like that. If they going to sign, they want him to stay off your ish. That's why he ain't been coming on your ish like that. So there was another message that just continue. Rain is a snake right along with the rest of them evil devils. Bees get paid very quick now. Let's see, hold on. It says, I'm only on when somebody calls and say you running my name. Nah, I mean, I ain't ran your name once, so, you know what I'm saying, let's keep it a buck. I don't know, you know how, yeah, come on, I know how the internet works. You should know how the internet works by now. Hey, man, you got to get on, man. Look, Ratchet, he popping that shit. Hey, Ratchet over there popping that shit about you. Hey, stop. Folks just need to grow up. Damn, they shouldn't have did that to Mo 3 point blank. Gang of folks for a man that's 5'1 or 5'2. Sean G, do you want to tap in real fast? Sean G, your name was only mentioned once Ratchet was reading D messages. Exactly. Nah, D running your name, they said. Sean G going to jail. Keep that up. Sean G is lurking. Damn, Sean G, you in it. Drop the link here. He says, drop the link here. All right, hold on. Give me a second. I'll drop it. Let's drop it. Give me 1 second. All right. I'm going to actually stop my content real quick, and we'll finish it. But I'll drop the link for you. You know what I'm saying? We unbiased at Ratchet Gang. So, golly, my texts are blowing up. Hold on. I pinned the link to the top of the chat. That's how you call into the show. You know what I'm saying? Well, you know how to do this. You be on the damn internet. Now, it ain't going to be no beef when my nigga's gone. Y'all listen to a mystery man. Drop the link here. All right. I dropped it. Give me a second, gang. What's good?
What's poppin'?
You tell me.
Look here, I'm gonna give you the same opportunity I give everybody else. Before you run my name, if you need some facts, hit my inbox. Hit my line. I'm always right here. I ain't nowhere too far.
Alright, so you wanna address what D said, or?
I don't even know who the fuck D is. D is a motherfucking mystery man. This nigga jump up on air platforms, running some shit he think going on. This shit be lame. Some of these people in these chats and you bloggers, nigga, you use your brain. Your brain will tell you everything.
Okay, so why you get mad at the messenger whenever I didn't present this shit?
I'm not mad at the messenger. I got a call that said you was running my name, so I tapped in.
All right, well, your call lied to you.
Well, you mentioning my name.
Well, actually, D mentioned your name. I just read the messages.
Yeah. What's his number?
I can't give you a number on the internet. I mean, you know what I'm saying, while we live and shit.
Listen, I give D $10,000 if he come on your channel with some facts on me. I don't know about nobody else. I'm just talking about me. I got 10K for whoever the fuck this mystery D nigga is that knows so much.
Oh, my bad. I didn't mean to do that. My bad. Go ahead. You said you got 10,000 for what?
The mystery man, D.
And put some receipts on you.
Put some receipts on me. I got 10,000 for anybody that can come put some receipts on me.
Okay, so the allegations, that's what people been saying about. This is not coming from whoever. This is shit that these street niggas are saying. Like I said, this is all coming from some street shit.
Who? What street shit? Give me one.
Look at what the chat is saying. That's what the streets are saying. I'm not gonna put nobody name in this shit. I mean, y'all know what's going on. Y'all in the streets. Y'all know what's up.
I'm not in the streets. I'm on house arrest.
Well, whoever in the streets, they know what's up.
Yeah, they don't know what's up either, because nobody y'all ever talk about ever seen me, ever been around me. I'm a whole different type of nigga. I don't hang with niggas. Don't nobody know my business. Nobody.
So do you want to address the Fed shit that everybody been talking about?
Come on, run it. What is it?
I mean, they saying the PR bond. Go ahead and let them. You saying your casework got messed up.
I never said my casework got messed up. Go show me one interview or one part where I said they messed up my case.
Hold on.
Show me one.
You didn't say that.
Show me one where I said that.
I could have sworn that you said something.
Never said that. Never. Show me one.
All right, chat. Did he say that shit?
No, don't ask that. I said, go find it. I don't speak nothing but facts, homie.
So, okay, what happened? How'd you get a PR bond?
When you go to the feds, you cannot get a bond out the feds. You cannot bond out the feds. They're going to come pick your ass up. You're going to get locked up. You can't use the phone until you get transported to your housing unit, wherever the fuck you're going to be at. You feel me? Then you're going to wait a whole another 24 hours for them to process your information and get you a code so you can use the phone. Then you're going to sit in that bitch until you get a court date. When you get a court date, the prosecutor's got to prove that you either a flight risk or a threat to society. If they cannot prove that, you get out on a PR bond. If they prove it, your ass sitting in there until your final court date.
So you're saying you didn't get out because your paperwork got messed up. You got out. Say it again. You got out because of what now?
They could not prove that I was a flight risk or a threat to society.
All right. I mean, that's what you said.
If you take a look at the Young Dolph case, I mean, not the Young Dolph. What's his nigga name? Young Thug. Why they not let him out?
I don't know.
They think he's a threat to society.
But he also not cooperating either.
cooperating. What is it to cooperate? He can't tell on himself.
I mean, if he would give up some people, I'm pretty sure he would have got out. I'm pretty sure if a lot of them dudes would start cooperating, they'd get out.
Yeah, he cooperate. He out of there. Just know, if you cooperate with them people, your name is in the paperwork. Your name is in black and white.
Okay, so you saying you never said that your casework got messed up. You never said that.
Never said that. Listen, when the feds come for you, they got facts. They not coming with no allegations.
I'm going to be honest with you. I heard you say that.
You heard me say what?
That your casework got messed up.
How do your casework get messed up with the feds?
Then you tell me. I'm telling you that I heard you say it.
Yeah, nigga, you ain't never heard me say that. Stop the cap.
The room heard. I mean, I'm not the only one who heard that. Listen, I mean, listen, I heard it, but
listen. Pull it up. Pull it up, and I'll send your ass some cash out.
I mean, I'm pretty sure that doesn't exist no more.
What? No more?
I mean, yeah. I'm a YouTuber. You can edit this shit.
This is what I'm saying. I like YouTube niggas that stand on business. You feel me? That stick to their shit. Now, if you don't hear telling your people the truth all the time, I fuck with you. I don't have no problem with you. But when you do the clickbait and the cap, I can't fuck with that, bro. You ain't never heard me say no shit like that. That shit don't even make no sense, bro.
I mean, other people would come up here and say that. I mean, I'm not making this up, so I don't want you to feel like I'm against you.
Bro, I want you to pull up the facts. I only like to talk facts. I don't want to speak allegations.
Beautiful, what's up?
Okay, let's look at it from this perspective. Your enemies will become friends for one common goal. That is to eliminate their problem. What was the problem? That's been stated. That's been stated over and over again. But let's see who stands up to everything that you've put out on your platform, Ratchet. Line them up. Line them up. Every single person that you think has some, we as a platform, has something to do with it. And see who stands the test.
So what are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is, Mo was a beast. I'm from Los Angeles, California. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't see niggas get liked up like Mo for less than. Because when you pump fear in another man's heart and you make their heart beat slow on the wrong side, and they can't come at you one-on-one, they can't see you on fighting, they can't see you on shooting, they can't see you on no level and no street shit, they gonna go recruit your enemies. Because they stronger together than they are alone.
Salute.
I mean, all I'm saying is, yeah, Rain has something to do with it. He did. Who is the closest to him? The closest gets the most is, baby, he's a snake.
So if you think Rain has something to do with this man right here on the screen, still cool with Rain. So you saying
But see, what you have to understand is you can't expect another man to base his relationship and friendship off what another man is going through with another man. That's where everybody's missing the facts. Everybody has their own relationships. I know how to be biased.
So you're saying even if Rain took Mo 3 out or had something to do with Mo 3 being taken out, he would put that aside and be like, hey.
It ain't that he can't put it aside. When you in the street shit, it's just certain things that you can't do. It's just certain things.
Let me tell you something about me. Anybody I know had something to do with 3 getting killed, I ain't got nothing to say to them. I ain't got nothing. Man, it's a whole nother world. I gotta be careful what I say.
And I totally understand because you are under house arrest.
I ain't got nothing to do with nobody that got something against 3.
Okay, so in your heart, do you feel like, well, you really can't say too much, but just do you feel like Rain got anything to do with it? I mean, have he showed you any type of deception, any type of shady stakery? Have you smelled it?
About 3?
No, about Rain. You say you're not gonna be friends with nobody that would do something the most, so you ain't suspected no shady shit from Rain. You ain't seen no snake shit.
Listen, let me answer this like this. I don't trust nobody. My loyalty was the 3. My partner not able to tell me nothing that was going on. So I don't trust nobody. Everybody is who they is.
And I respect that. And guess what? Your loyalty was to 3, and I salute you for keeping your loyalty to him. But you do have to sit back and peep everybody and look at it from the outside, looking in and seeing all perspectives, not just the tunnel vision 2-way. So I understand exactly what you're saying. All I'm saying is, from
Sean G, hold on, sweetie, hold on, give me a second. Sean G, were you locked up when Mo 3 was died?
No.
And where were you?
I was at home. I was in the streets.
In Oak Cliff and where?
No, I was off of Mockingbird.
Okay, and did you end up in a car with Rain?
That never happened.
Okay, so D lied about that.
Never happened.
Were you ever on the freeway at any point?
I was on 35 in Mockingbird when I got the call. I shot from Mockingbird to the location. Anybody with common sense to notice the freeway was blocked. You couldn't do nothing. You couldn't get over there.
And how'd you get the location?
Rain called me.
How did Rain get the location?
I have no idea.
So you never questioned it?
I question a lot of things.
Okay. Got you. Who was Rain on the phone with Mo3 when Mo3 died? To your knowledge?
I have no idea.
Did you go to the hospital?
I was the first one at the hospital.
Was he pronounced dead at that time?
Nah.
Did you see him?
Yep.
And what did he say to you?
What did who say to me?
You said you seen Mo3.
Yeah, I seen him pull him out the ambulance.
Okay, dude, was he cool?
See, he was just there.
Did he look at you?
No.
Did you ever get to see him in the hospital, no?
No. The laws came and got me before all of that even happened. I found out 3 was dead while I was in what's that, the first 48 building.
And why did they take you?
They had some questions. They want to know if I knew anything or what was happening. Or I don't know nothing.
And how long were you gone?
How long was I gone where?
You said they took you. How long did you stay gone?
Shit, I don't know. I was probably in there about 15, 20 minutes.
Okay.
Once they told me he passed, it was time to go.
Gotcha. Okay. Beautiful. You got any questions?
Has anybody really looked at that airport footage with Rain and that boy Kenny G and what that boy Kenny B, he was really saying? If I listen to it and I listen to it over again, he kept saying, he over there snitching. He over there telling the police I killed his partner. If Rain don't know who killed Mo3, how is he going to accuse you of killing Mo3?
I never seen that footage.
Rain and that boy in the airport, and he wanted to fight Rain outside the airport.
I'm pretty sure you've seen that Kenny B footage by now.
And then, did you, not to cut you off, Kenny G, I'm sorry, but did you also listen to what
Rain... His name is Sean G.
Sean G. I'm thinking about the jazz guy. But did anybody peep the part when he was saying, I'm going to text you? How you going to text the nigga that post that killed your partner? To meet up. Those are just other small gems. Because why are you telling these people? Why are you going to the, airport police talking about he killed your friend? Well, if he killed your friend, did you tell the feds that? But you don't know who killed Mo, though.
Sean G saying he never seen that footage.
You see what I'm saying, Ratchet? You feel what I'm saying? I don't know if anybody else peeped that, but Rain kept telling, oh, I'm going to text you. He said, no, you ain't going to text me.
It's okay. I got it right here. Since Sean G has never seen it, Ratchet going to show him for the first time. Hold on. I'm gonna show you. This is what we're talking about right here. Check this out.
Yeah. That nigga Rain, hey, baby, you said same Rain while in the airport. He talking about, you killed my partner. You killed my partner all in front of the police. Bitch, that nigga about killed your partner. Do something. Nigga, know what I told him in his face. If I kill my partner, do something.
Could it go right there? We're letting him go left, right? We're hoping they go left from the game. He got a girl now?
Look at him talking to them boys, telling that nigga on King, that nigga telling, bitch ass.
Clubhouse ass nigga, let's go outside and fight, like I said.
I'm at the airport, look, we gonna meet up.
I'm my mama, if we say meet up, you is not gonna text me back, you is not gonna meet up.
Put on my chat. On my child. Like,
you say what?
On my child, nigga.
Say that. Clubhouse ass nigga, let's go outside and fight, like I said.
I'm at the airport, look, we gonna meet.
So there we go. That's Kenny B. Kiki, what's up?
Mo gave Rain more credit for being smart than he should have.
Kiki, what's up?
This is for what's the lady name right here?
Beautiful.
Yes, you. I don't know why you interrogating or whatever you.
I'm not interrogating anybody, honey. I'm not interrogating anybody.
Let her speak, beautiful. Let her speak.
But it's like, I feel like they already got the people they wanted. Like, the Devin Brown guy and what's his name? The other guy. So I don't know why y'all prolonging this shit. Like,
okay.
If they had any other people, they would have been picked them up by now.
So. Okay. Baby girl, not to be funny, I'm not interrogating anybody, but I had two cousins go do 30 years a piece almost for not snitching. I'm gonna say that for once again, for not snitching. So yes, there is people sitting in jail for things that they didn't do. There's some people in jail that's getting paid to sit down and take a case. Them boys didn't do that. Them boys did not do that. And let me tell you something, when it's a Fed case, a RICO case, they gonna let you bop around. They gonna let you talk. They gonna let you do all of that. Because see, if they, like they said, if
hold
it's
on,
money
hold on,
involved,
beautiful.
If it's money
hold
involved.
Hold on, beautiful. Hold on, beautiful. LaShawn G, what color pants did Mo3 have on when you saw him?
I didn't see all that. They had a blanket over his hat, lower hat.
So what do you think about Rain saying Mo3 had on black pants and that person that they had on the freeway was not Mo3?
You said what?
He said that was not Mo3 that was laying on the freeway in that video, because Mo3 had on black pants and that person in the video had on purple pants. He said that was an edited picture. That's what Rainwater said.
Yeah, I don't know nothing about that.
Do you believe that was Mo3 laying on that freeway in that picture?
Yeah, I believe.
So you believe Mo3 is dead and that's it?
Man, I know this man is not hurt.
Did you see him deceased?
I don't know if he was alive or deceased when I saw him.
So how can you come to that conclusion?
Because I know his family.
Did anybody see him deceased? Because what I was told is nobody identified a dead body. That's what I was told. Maybe that's not true.
Yeah, see, this again, what I'm talking about. Y'all keep talking about what y'all was told. I don't do accusations. I only deal with facts.
Okay, so let's go facts. Did anybody see a dead body?
Who is anybody? I don't know what you're talking about.
Do you know of anyone who saw Mo3 deceased?
I'm pretty sure his mother.
No, you're pretty sure. Are you 100% sure? Pretty sure.
Bro, I'm not finna play the particular game.
No, I'm just saying. Do you? It's just
ask me a question that makes sense.
I know. But
hold on. Let me ask. Let me get this off. The question is: do you know if anybody saw him deceased?
My partner not hurting him up.
But you can't answer that question.
My partner not here no more.
Go ahead, Kiki.
I was going to say, I know for sure Mo3 did, because I'm cool with one of his cousins and we like close. So she tells me everything. So he's dead. He's not here.
I mean, nobody can present factual evidence of that. But y'all go ahead. I'm listening.
So where is he at?
And you tell me. It sounds like you might know somebody. It sounds like you sound real familiar though.
Listen, we ain't gonna play my partner name like that. My partner not hurt no more. That's just that. Y'all play too much.
I'm gonna be honest with you, Sean G. I don't think anybody's playing here.
Yeah, y'all playing too much.
No, I believe he's dead.
My partner not hurt no more. His family. His son got to deal with all that shit. Let that be what it is. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, all these conspiracy theories, y'all play too much.
I don't feel like anybody's playing.
Yeah, that's just how you feel. That's your personal perception.
Do y'all not have any respect for his mama? Like, what about how his mama feel? Like, y'all over here saying, oh, her son not dead. Okay, like.
Who said he wasn't? Who said he was or what? I don't know if he is or not. I can't tell
your
you.
Your conspiracy saying, oh.
What is my conspiracy? Tell me what my conspiracy is.
You saying, you questioning this man saying, do you think your partner dead?
Is that not a realistic question to ask?
No, it's not.
How would that not be a realistic
question? They had a funeral for this man, everything, a grave site for this man.
So you're telling me in the history of man, there's never been a funeral?
Who finna waste their time?
Okay, so let me ask you a question. Is in the history of mankind, has there ever been a fake funeral? Has anyone ever faked their death in the history of mankind? Okay, thanks.
Bro, you got some more questions for me? What's up?
Nah, I mean, you wanted to call in. I mean, I'm good.
Like, who finna play around with, like, grave sites and shit? Like, that shit weird. Like, who finna do all that shit?
I don't know who does what. I'm not, look, y'all getting mad at me. Like, I'm saying everything. And
I'm not mad. I'm just saying, like, he from Dallas. He well known. So, this man. Okay.
Have you seen a death certificate, sweetheart? Let me ask y'all that then. Since I'm
Have you seen a death certificate?
Hell no, I haven't.
Okay, then. That's not. Is it public?
Yeah, they are. There you go.
But then too, also, yeah. Not to cut
y'all
you
don't
off.
Y'all don't want to do this with me.
No, then not to cut you off, but you know, like, certain marriage certificates are considered confidential, that they won't be a part of public record. You can pay extra money for your marriage certificate in the state of California to be made confidential, so no one can know that you're married. But if you don't pay the extra money in California, it will become public record. Now, in Mo 3 case, it could then make his death certificate could be confidential, where it's not accessible to the public for certain reasons.
I just was asking the question, has anybody seen one? I haven't. Maybe y'all have. I don't know.
No, I haven't. I mean, they said they haven't, but no one may have not seen it due to that it may be confidential.
Brent, I heard y'all on there talking about me, man.
What's up, man?
Oh, Snakey Bake is on, huh?
Hey, look, hey, y'all see Baby C, man. And Baby C just rocked the shit out of Kevin Gates to it, man. Y'all, everybody go follow the real Baby C.
Here go clown. Here go the clown. Here go the clown.
Everybody go follow the real Baby C.
Here go the
C,
clown.
Man,
you clown. Let the clown have the floor.
Hey, baby, listen. Listen, baby, y'all go follow the real Baby C. Y'all go follow the
MVP. Hey, how did you get Mo3's location whenever you called Sean G with it?
Mo3 location. I don't know. Look at it. Listen.
No.
Matter of fact, listen.
How did you get that location, Rain?
Listen.
Rain, how did you know where Mo3 was? How did you get his location when he died?
Listen, he said it in this song finna come out called Wade in the Water. He said he was tired of waiting in the water, so y'all look out for Wade in the Water finna come out.
I appreciate
The album Legend finna come out. You know, going number one.
Mo3 has an album called Legend, which is the name of your son.
Yeah, because he was a legend. Mo3 was a big legend, man. He's a Texas legend, man. And when y'all got to hear these new songs, man, I'm telling y'all got to hear these new songs. He got a song called Wade in the Water. He was tired.
Let the clown have a platform.
Yeah, he was tired of waiting in that water, man. Y'all got to stay tuned.
How you know he was tired of waiting in the water? What was he waiting in the water
for? He said in the song,
man.
He said he was tired. Wait till y'all heard his song.
Right. You know what? Mo gave you more credit for having more sense and being educated than you are. You are making a total ass of yourself.
Well, that's cool, ma'am. I'm not here to be nothing. I'm just on here just promoting. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day. So, you know, Mo3, and you making an ass of yourself because you 50 years old talking about a bunch of shit you don't know
about.
You don't
know if I'm 50 years old or not. I know that you was mad because he called you scary on the internet. I know that you was scary on the internet, Brian. It's okay, though. He just didn't want nobody beating up on his manager that was not from the streets because you was a straight wing. He knew that you wasn't cut from that cloth. And he called himself trying to defend your whole ass. And you got mad. So listen. Now what? Promote that.
Listen. Y'all go follow my YouTube. I'm finna go live and tell y'all the shit going on. Everybody go follow my YouTube channel right now. Click the button, go follow my YouTube channel, and I'm gonna tell y'all what's really going on. I might tell y'all the date that the album's gonna come out, man. You know.
We'll wait.
So how did you get Mo3's location and give it to Sean G?
Because that nigga say I was tired of being broke, I had to find a way. Jump in that water 1,000 times. Put that on God. I'm like, the weight in the water.
Now, Sean G, I got a question.
Sean G hung up.
Yeah, y'all go look at y'all go listen. Y'all go listen to that weight in the water, man. That's a bad motherfucker for to come out, man.
Ryan, why you just want to answer the question?
I don't know nothing about all that, man. I'm like,
Listen. Yeah, so you wasn't mad because he called you Barry on the internet. You wasn't mad because
of that. Man, listen.
So, y'all right, let me ask you this.
Y'all been doing this for 2 years, man. Listen.
Did you see the Bible?
Listen, I can't speak on that. I know people out there take raping girls and all kind of shit. We need to be talking about y'all talking about some goofy shit, man.
And we talking to a nigga that like to snipe his homeboys and fuck his bitches behind his back. So what makes you any different?
Ma'am, you got a cartoon as your fucking emojis. You shut your old ass up.
I'm not old, motherfucker. I'm not old. But you are a snake. You can say whatever you want to say about me, because what you say don't make me shit at all, my nigga. Niggas like you in L.A.
You
get put in barrels.
You get your old ass out there, man.
How do you figure I'm old? How do you figure I'm old?
You 52 years old.
I'm not 52 years old,
but boo-boo. How old are you, man?
I am 43.
I'm 43. You are with a 22-year-old son.
I don't have a 22-year-old son, sir. I have a 27-year-old daughter that works for the Department of Social Services.
Stop taking yourself off of you, beautiful. Go ahead.
Bitch, you was an old freak.
Go ahead and get in there, legacy, or whoever that
is. I know your mama is an old freak.
Stop taking yourself off mute, beautiful.
I keep telling you, I'm going to bring you back up.
Hey Ratchet, let me tell you something. That nigga, baby C said, you did me wrong, but I feel like you was right. And then I'm like, why? He said, it's okay, because I'm out your way. I'm gone tonight. He said, he's leaving tonight. He said, all these problems that he had in his life, fighting depression and stress and losing his mind. That's deep. That nigga said it out of his motherfucking mouth. Y'all go follow up the real baby C. That nigga said it out of his mouth.
All right, go ahead.
Hey, listen, the only thing that I can say is I've been following you, Ratchet, since Kanika. Okay. So my point is this. Okay, Sean G get up here tonight and say something that just totally threw me off because I thought he was down.
Hold on, who got their TV playing in the background? Whoever got the TV in the background, please turn it off.
Okay, I'm sorry. Maybe it's me. So I will say this. For Rainwater and all these other people up here, okay, so when Mo 3 pop out, what the hell y'all going to do?
What the man gonna pop out?
Okay, so Rand, listen, with your dribble lip ass, you know, you talk a good game, but you don't walk a good game. As a man, you got to learn, youngster, how to walk and talk your truth. And you're not walking or talking.
So you said Mo 3 would tell you, hold up.
Like you say when you dribbling, listen, you
I ain't never
need
heard
to
him say that in my life. You just made that shit up. Mo 3 ain't never said no, hold up. You just made that shit up.
A lot of things, baby. Listen, you about to get caught up, sir.
Caught up in what?
You about to get caught up. No,
shut the fuck up. Y'all get y'all old ass out there up this thing. Y'all need to get a life and go to church tomorrow and pay y'all goddamn time. Let's go.
You're so disrespectful. You better find that you don't have daughters or son who can get the caught up.
He just left his son.
Okay, so you need to take heed to a lot of things that you don't. Rainwater, you're such a coward. You're a coward. You're not a man. You're not a man. I wish you'd come down south and talk the shit that you talk, because then somebody will whop your ass, like Carly B said. You can't do it. And the problem is, when Mo 3 pop out, he gonna pop out. You talking the shit that you want to say, and you running scared right now. There's a lot of shit that you scared about, okay? And it's going to come, and you're going to see. You're going to see, and you're going to know. And when Ratchet TV put out stuff for y'all to understand, listen, I like Ratchet. Sometimes I don't like a lot of the content that he put on, how the way he talked to people.
Hold on,
but
wait,
I like
him. Wait,
what? Right. I have a question, Ratchet. Can I ask you this?
You just said you like me, but you don't like my content. Hold on.
Right. Okay. Let me ask y'all a question.
Go ahead.
I like to know this, y'all. So since
I ain't packed somebody up in a long time. Girl, grab your briefcase, your purse, your Ratchet Gang fanny pack. Pack it up. All right, go ahead.
You know, since everybody confused and like you said, nobody identified a body.
Listen,
Ratchet,
y'all don't.
Wait 1 second, Rainwater. Let me ask you this.
Y'all don't fucking let me come back on here for a whole year. Ooh, I'm finna make
somebody has to identify that man's body before, when he passed away. So
listen,
that's what I would like to know. Can we ask him that?
Listen, Rainwater. Hey, Rats, y'all don't let me get back on here and promote. Man, wait till this album drop. We're gonna do this for 3 months, y'all. We're gonna do this for 3 motherfucking months, right? You hear me?
I like to know why he think it's a joke.
Watch it go.
Give me roll, yeah.
Y'all don't let me back on here. Listen,
I'm gonna leave. Ratchet, can you please follow who identified his body? Who identified most of his body?
Y'all gonna follow the real baby C right now?
He look goofy and you look goofy.
Ma'am, you two damn old y'all here. Ma'am, listen, y'all gonna follow.
He look goofy and you look goofy.
Do this remind y'all of anything right here?
Yeah,
we ain't trying to hit that.
Let me drop y'all some. We're going to talk about that next week. Ratchet, we're going to bring it up next week. Hey, we need 2 months of this, y'all. Stretches out 2 months. We got Mo 3 album for the drop. Dun-Dun, the album drop. Everybody go listen to Dun-Dun album. Y'all go see if do it sound like anything y'all ever heard before. Y'all go search it. Life of a Soldier. Dun-Dun gave y'all some
clues. Fuck that album.
Yeah, y'all go run.
Right,
go
ahead,
Big Dog said he got some gems to give. Go ahead, Big Dog.
Hey, y'all, check this out. Peep this. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I've been in and out of jail all my life. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to say this. The people that's in jail for that Mo 3 shit, they just the fall guys. I worked with Devin Brown, older brother. I don't want to put his name on this platform. We worked at the Frito-Lay off in Wheatland. And I know for a fact, them two guys, they gonna get off that fed shit behind that Mo 3
they already been acquainted with federal charges, so the federal charge had nothing to do. They already pled guilty to the feds. Rats, what type of niggas y'all got on her line and shit?
They gonna get off.
He hung up. Yeah.
But they gonna get off that Mo 3 and shit because they the foul fucking guys. Devin Brown, him and Benz on Bling didn't do that shit. They the foul fucking guys. If y'all look at the video, Trump Boy fading them, that was riding on the down freeway, laughing, joking behind the shit. You know what I'm saying? I talked to Devin Brown brother every other day to know that Devin didn't do the shit. The shit bigger than what's being put out.
Tell me what you know. Tell me what they're telling you without telling me too much.
Hey, Devin Brown and Benzo Bling were the ones that was on that freeway that day that ran Mo 3 down. I do know that much.
Okay, so go ahead. What else can you tell me?
I can't speak too much behind it. I'm going to let the folks do their job.
But you're saying that Devin Brown and Kiwan did not kill Mo 3?
No, they didn't.
Okay, I got you.
Loud and clear on that one. No, they didn't. They gonna beat that murder charge behind Mo 3. The shit bigger than that. You know what I'm saying? Mo 3 has so much plex in the DFW all together that everybody wanted him gone. You know what I'm saying? The shit bigger than that. You know what I'm saying? I'm out though, y'all. You know what I'm saying? I just wanted to say that because everybody getting on this shit, talking about this and that ain't this, and whatever you like to say, you know what I'm saying? That's not it, man. That's not the case, you know what I'm saying? The shit bigger than that. I ain't know what the fuck going on, you know what I'm saying? Just like everybody in the club, you know what I'm saying? South Dallas, okay, everybody.
So let me ask you a question while you're up here. What did you think about when Sean G called in? What you think about that?
He a solid dude, you know what I'm saying? Sean G... him and Bubba was the only two real ones on 3-10. The only two real ones. Everybody else was snakes around them. You know what I'm saying? I don't even trust number 7. I don't trust.